in this conduction. It is actually, of course, you know it. Conduction is related to transfer of heat through conduct solids, that I know. And through the solids, here suppose when a rod of certain cross-sectional area means, you know, in your mathematics, which is perpendicular to the length, the area measured perpendicular to the length, and its length is L. And here the two ends are maintained at the temperatures like theta naught and theta 1. And I'm taking theta naught is the hotter end and theta 1 is the colder end. Okay. And in this case, if the thermal conductivity is K, then what is the amount of rate of heat flow? Means amount of heat flow per second. If I ask, I think you can say the formula for it, heat flow by the method of conduction through solids, okay, rate of heat flow, which is called as thermal power. Why? Because energy by time is the power. So thermal power, which is Q by T, is equals to, of course, you can say, which is of course, the other name is rate of heat flow, is equals to Ka into, I think you can say, delta theta by L. Okay. First, related to this formula, Nana, what I'm asking, here, at a particular cross section, somewhere in the middle, say some at a distance X. Okay. If the temperature is theta, then how to measure that temperature theta? Okay. Okay. Then here, first of all, now while solving the problems, take care. We solve in the method of by the method of conduction. Okay, the rate of heat flow while measuring. Okay, in conductors. Means in solids, first of all, they have to mention it is reached the steady state. Okay. And here, even though it is not mentioned that the rod is reached the steady state, okay, we have to consider it is reached to the steady state. Okay. In the steady state, the rate of heat flow is equals to Ka into delta theta by L. Steady state means, keep in mind, Nana, while transferring the heat is not absorbed by the molecules of the rod. Okay. Means, suppose it is at 100 degrees Celsius and that is at 0 degrees Celsius. Of course, at different cross section, while going to the other end, the temperature gradually decreases. Okay. What I am saying is, at a distance x, theta is equal to say some 90 degrees at one instant, okay? At all the instant, that cross section maintains 90 degrees. It won't be changed, okay? So here, steady state means different cross sections will be at different temperatures, but those temperatures will be constant. That is one point that what we have to remember. Steady state. And here, second point, actually the heat is flowing along its length, Nana, from higher temperature to lower temperature. Along its length means like this, the heat is flowing. Means indirectly you are saying that there is no heat flow through the sides. Okay. Means they have to mention this is insulated. Means this is the rod and the rod is here insulated. Suppose it is insulated like this. Means not allowing the heat flow through the sides. Heat is flowing only parallel to the length. Then only we have to apply this formula. Okay. In this case, okay. But there is no heat flow through the side walls and the heat is flowing from one side to the other side parallel to its length. Okay. At that instant, if they ask at one particular cross section, what is the temperature which is at a distance of x from hotter end? Okay, this will be easier, Nana. Why? Because here heat is flowing and no heat is absorbed by the molecules of the material. Means whatever the heat you are sending per second here, the total heat per second reaches to the other end without losing in the middle by neglecting the radiation. Okay, so here the rate of heat flow, whatever you are saying, that is equals to constant. Okay, in steady state you can see rate of heat flow is constant. Means according to this formula, you can say Ka into delta theta by L is constant. Here this is completely one rod. One rod means the thermal conductivity, coefficient of thermal conductivity. Okay, that thermal conductivity is same throughout the rod. K is constant and it is uniform cross sectional, so area is constant. Q by T is already a constant. Why? Because it is reached to the steady state. Therefore, you can say delta theta by L is equals to constant. Okay, this is appeared like d theta by dx is equals to constant in differential form. Okay, from this you can say here, suppose in numerical, if I ask, Nana, this is one uniform cross sectional rod, here it is logged, Nana, logged means insulated, and one end I am maintaining at 100 degrees centigrade, other end I am maintaining 20 degrees Celsius. Suppose total length is 1 meter, Nana, say 100 centimeters, or better you take some 60 centimeters. Okay, suppose if I ask from our hotter end at a distance of 20 centimeters, what will be the temperature? Okay, then here think wisely, Nana. What I said across the rod, delta theta by delta x constant means you can take here to there. Delta theta is 100 minus theta by delta x, that is 20 for this cross section, Nana. And you can say for the other part, total 60 means this is 40 centimeters. It is 40 centimeters. So here delta theta by delta x means delta theta is theta minus 20 by delta x, that is 40, okay, which is equals to delta theta. You can write even for the full length of the rod, delta theta 100 minus 20 divided by L, that is 6. Likewise, you can write, Nana, and you can find out what is the temperature at a particular cross section when it is reached the steady state and the sides are insulated, that is logged. Okay, then directly you can say the answer here. Of course, better, it is easy to by equating these. That is 100 minus theta by 20 is equals to, this is 80 by 60. Directly you can say the answer. Okay, 2/4 are 2. So 100 minus theta is equals to 80 by 3. So theta is equals to much. Okay. That is one method, Nana. Right? Finding out the theta. And related to this one, instead of asking the basic model here, okay, find out the temperature at a particular cross section when it reaches the steady state. Suppose if they ask how the temperature at a particular cross section changes with the distance, draw a graph by taking theta on y axis, x on x, the distance x from left hand on x axis. Okay, here hotter end is theta naught, and colder end I am taking theta 1. And here at one particular cross section, like in the problem, I am asking. But instead of numerical, I am asking it graph. Okay. At a distance x, take the total length as L. Okay. In the numerical, actually, what you did 100 minus theta. Okay. By that distance, in the same way, theta naught minus theta, like 100 minus theta, theta naught minus theta by L. Means by dx, this is here x is equals to, I equated to the total part, 100 minus 20, that is theta naught minus theta 1 by here 60, total length is L. Okay, I am asking theta naught, therefore you will get the answer theta is equals to theta naught minus, okay, theta naught minus theta 1 by L into x. Okay, if you simplify that equation, it is exactly appeared like theta naught, it is constant and maintaining at a constant temperature of 100, means theta naught is constant. This is maintained at a constant temperature of 20. So theta 1 is constant. Total length of the rod is 60, it is constant. So in this part, everything is a constant. That constant, suppose you take it as some m, okay, it is appear like minus mx plus theta naught. Theta naught is some constant c, is equals to theta. Theta means y-axis. Theta is taken on y-axis. So it is appeared like y is equals to minus mx plus c. Means it is a straight line, surely. Straight line, but with a negative slope. Okay. So negative slope means here we have to get a straight line like this. Okay. Whereas with a negative slope means here the temperature gradually decreases. Decreases from what? From hotter end. That is theta naught. Starts from theta naught. And it is gradually decreasing like this. Yes, right. Okay. This was one question previously given in mains. Generally, we expect actually the numerical questions like this, but he gave this type of question, what will be the shape? Okay. And here, suppose this one, if you extend a bit deep into the concept, like in an advanced type of questions, suppose here this rod is not logged. Not logged means not insulated. Means the side walls are not insulated. But it is reached the steady state. Okay. And here as usual, hotter is theta naught I am taking. And colder I am taking here theta 1. Okay. And as usual, how the temperature theta changes with the distance x? If they ask, okay. Surely you won't get there a straight line, Nana. Why? Because heat is flowing along the length as well as along the sideways line. Okay. Why? Because the sides are not insulated. So in that case, okay, if you solve, of course, there you will get one second order differential equation, Nana, that I am not explaining now. Okay. So here, finally, after solving that one, second order differential means already I told in some chapter, oscillations like in damped oscillations, you will get some exponential type of equation. Here you will get that temperature at some instant, theta is equals to, you will get like theta naught into e power minus lambda x. Okay. Suppose in exam, if you require what is the value of lambda also there, then that lambda is equals to here root of Ep by Ka. Okay. Then I think no need to say about K and A. K, you know, coefficient of thermal conductivity. A is not surface area, area of cross section. And here E is actually emissivity number. Okay, and here P is the perimeter of the rod. Right, And related to this one, if they asked same the graph here, okay, such a type of graph, what will be the shape? Okay, there I think no need to say it is exponential graph, sir, theta, and it is x, and again it is decreasing, sir, decreasing exponential starting from theta is equals theta naught. Means if you put x is equals to 0, you will get theta equals to theta naught. So yet x is equals to 0 theta naught, and later on it is decreasing exponentially like this. Okay, means you can easily remember nana. Why? Because this type of graph I think you already got in natural radioactivity. Due to the decay, the number of nuclei present in the substance at an instant, n is equals to n naught into e power minus lambda t. There also you will get the same type of graph, number of nuclei present in the radioactive substance, how it changes with the time. Okay, this is exactly identical to radioactivity graph. Okay, where the number of nuclei present in radioactive substance, we take it as m naught initially and then exponentially decrease. Okay, right. This is one story, Nana. Right? Why I interrelated there? If you get an identical graph there, like in radioactivity, immediately there you measured what is the half-life time. Half-life time means the time taken to reduce the number of nuclei to half. Okay, so same type of question if they ask here, but it is not changing with the time now, it is changing with the distance. Okay, changing with the distance means at what distance, okay, the theta becomes exactly theta naught by 2. Okay, means in the same way if you write here theta is equals to theta naught by 2 is equals to theta naught into e power minus lambda x, you will get the same type of equation, Anna. 2 is equals to lambda x, that implies e power lambda x, that implies log 2 is equals to lambda x, that implies distance from hotter end x is equals to lambda 2 by lambda. Okay, there the t half in the same way you got t half is equals to lambda 2 by lambda, log 2 by lambda. Okay, that's why here if you are unable to find out just remember it is identical to a half life time, you can put this type of option in exam. Okay, simply at what distance the theta is reduced to half of the temperature of hotter end. Simple, you can write. Okay, this is one model, Nana. In this rod, Nana, if this is one part of length x, okay, made of material K. Look at here in this model, areas of cross section same. Okay, temperatures are theta naught and theta. For example, second part area of cross section is also given different like this. Okay, and here this part of length is L minus x by taking the total length L. And it is same way. Made of different material 2k. Area of cross section, suppose here k, there 2a. Then what will be the temperature at the junction? Here if I ask, okay, this one also you can say, I think, when compared to the previous one, in the total formula, dq by dt is equal to ka into delta theta by L. dq by dt, obviously they are in series, so constant. Previously, the advantage what we got, areas of cross section constant. That's why we wrote K into delta theta by L equals to constant. I think this time what to write, Nana?
K into delta theta by L equals to
constant. We have to include A also. So K A into delta theta by L is equals to constant. Just to we can put in steady state, the two in series, only dq by dt is equals to constant. Okay. Again, for two materials, directly we can substitute. Okay. This is one method, Nana. And here, sometimes we can apply the shortcuts also. What is the shortcuts? This is one method. It is correct. Okay. One more method. Method two here to solve such type of problems. Okay. You can interlink this concept with the electricity part, Nana. Okay. Physics everywhere, it is analogous. Here you are maintaining temperature difference. In electricity, we maintain potential difference. Okay. So potential difference is analogous to temperature difference here. Okay. And here, heat flow per second, their charge flow per second, the charge flow per second is current. So higher potential to lower potential, charge flows per second. Here heat flows per second. So there the current is analogous to dq by dt, that is q by t. It is analogous to q by t. Okay. And number three, here if you know delta V and I, why don't you apply the Ohm's law here also and you can find out what is the thermal resistance. Okay. Thermal resistance means there delta V is equals to I into R. Delta V is analogous to delta theta. I is analogous to dq by dt, q by t. So delta theta here is equals to dq by dt into, I have to write L by k. I am taking this part to the other hand. Okay. So delta theta is equals to L by k a into dq by dt. Okay. So if you see this equation, you can say what is the thermal resistance. Okay, that thermal resistance here is equals to L by K A. Right? This is the story, Nana. Okay. And here, if you see, it is identical to your electrical resistance also. Electrical resistance there is equals to, I think you remember, that is rho L by A, where rho is resistivity, okay? But we got K in the denominator, so instead of resistivity, I write here reciprocal of resistivity is conductivity, so I write conductivity into L by A, that is L by sigma, what I am saying, okay? See here, the electrical resistance and thermal resistance both are identical equations, okay? There it is sigma is electrical conductivity. Here K is thermal conductivity. Okay. So again, analogous if you write, the thermal conductivity here is analogous to electrical conductivity. Okay. And we say here, you have to remember that the thermal conductivity is independent of temperature. Okay, means actually this total chapter is related to temperature. Look at here, one end temperature is more, other end temperature is less. Suppose it is made of same material, then throughout the rod we say single material. Throughout the rod we say the thermal conductivity is K only. We won't say here K is more, there K is less. Means uniform. So K is actually independent of temperature for a single material here, what we say. Okay, general case now. Suppose if they mention K depends upon temperature, then we have to solve in a different way. General case, what I am saying, it is independent of temperature. But there, the thermal, sorry, electrical resistivity depends upon temperature. Nana. Okay, that's why in electricity, we write temperature coefficient of resistance also. That is represent, I think you know, previously we completed the electricity part. Temperature coefficient of resistance is equals to rho at a temperature T minus rho naught by rho naught into T V H. Okay, means here we have to write rho at a temperature T. Electrical resistivity is equals to rho naught into 1 plus alpha T. So with the increase of temperature, resistivity increases. Okay. So may not be directly proportional to T, but one increases, other also increases. Okay. So from that logic, if you see there, resistivity increases with the temperature means the conductivity, which is reciprocal of resistivity, decreases. Okay. Sigma is equals to 1 by rho naught. So with the increase of temperature, the conductivity decreases. So electrical conductivity, if you take, not thermal conductivity, it is independent of temperature. But thermal conductivity is dependent of temperature, and it is appeared like inversely proportional to the temperature. Okay, that's why related to this concept, one time he asked. Okay, previously that was given in BITSAT exam. In BITSAT exam, what he asked, suppose the thermal conductivity and the electrical conductivity both are analogous to each other. Okay, for a given material, the K by sigma depends on temperature as is directly proportional to what he asked. See here, if you know this concept, straight away you can put the option. Okay, see here, you can say the answer. It is directly proportional to what, Nana?
Temperature.
That's it, over. Okay, so if you know this concept, then K by sigma is directly proportional to the temperature. This one, what was given in BITSAT exam. Okay, so this is one more model here. Okay, so from this explanation, here I think you learnt the thermal resistivity R is equals to, which is L by KA. Okay, what is the use of this one, sir? Okay, suppose, Nana, here you can understand. If I give one question, it is very easy to understand, Nana. Right? Here, suppose if I give three materials, okay, of course made of, like given, this is one material, Nana, of thermal conductivity, okay, length L, area of cross section K, and this is another material here, okay, and this is the third material here. Three different materials are kept in contact, Nana, there. Okay, and the dimensions you see there, here its length is L and the length of this one is L by 2, made of material 2, okay. Here made of material K, okay, it is of area of cross section appear to be bigger, so K by 2, and sorry, 2A, and its area of cross section is here, this is either take A or A by 2, anything, okay. Better I take area of cross section is appear to be A small compared to this one, A by 2, and I take it as 2. Length is more. Okay, this is better. And here you are maintaining different temperatures at the two ends. Here 105 degrees Celsius and there 0 degrees Celsius. Okay, what will be the temperature at this cross section? Means like some theta 1 you take here, some theta 1. And at this cross section, means at the cross section where 1 and 2 are in contact, at the cross section where 2 and 3 are in contact. Okay. So he is asking, find the contact temperatures, Nana, theta 1 and theta 2. Right? One method you can solve, what, sir, since they are in series, Q by T anywhere constant, sir. Okay, different one, the areas are looking to be different, lengths looking to be different, K is different, looking to be different. So better I take it K A into delta theta by L equals to constant, sir. Okay, you can solve by that is one method. But there is a small problem, little bit flaw there. What? Suppose if you want to write the equation for the first one, okay, K, A delta theta, since it is higher temperature, 105 minus theta 1 by L, one equation. Constant means is equals to. Second one, what you write, theta 1 minus theta 2 by here, sorry, into K, 2K, KA, A is 2A by L. And third one here, this is theta 2 minus 0, first K, K, A by 2. And here theta 2 by theta 2 minus 0, that is theta 2, by L is 2A. Actually, we have to write like that, right? So, problem is, first of all, we have to find out by equating these two, theta 1, theta 2, two unknowns are there. One equation you will get. By equating these two or those two, you will get one more equation. There also theta 1 and theta 2. And two equations we have to solve. Okay, finally, you will get some answer. Okay, what is theta 1, what is theta 2? As my point of view, if you see, okay, here it is appeared to be a little bit bigger while solving. Okay. If you prefer, yes, it is well and good. Nothing wrong in it. But my point of view, this is what I said. My point of view, it is appeared to be a little bit bigger one. Means kills more time while solving the question. Okay. So if you want to save that time, my point of view is, why don't you use the electricity concept here? Okay, just know what I explained. Since they are in series, current will be same, that is Q by T equals to constant. Why don't we use the concept of when three resistors are in series, V1 is to V2 is to V3 is equals to R1 is to R2 is to R3 concept in series. Okay, that is in electricity. Potential difference is analogous to what, Nana, here? Is it temperature difference or some other?
Temperature difference.
Yeah. So, first one here, I write V1 as 105 minus theta 1 is to, second one is theta 1 minus theta 2 is to, V3 is here theta 2 minus 0, that is theta 2, is equals to my ratio R1 is to R2 is to R3. R is equals to L by Ka now. So L by Ka, first one. Second one, L is L only, by K is 2K, A is 2A, is to third one, L by K, L is 2L, by K is K into A by. So simple, you are getting L by K in all parts get cancelled. You are getting 1 is to 1 by 4 is to 4, nothing but 4 is to 1 is to 60. Okay, so total number of parts 21, Nana. Okay, so here total number of parts 21 means first part V1, what we write, 105 minus theta 1, you are almost getting the answer, theta 1 value. V1 is equals to parts, 4 parts of total number of parts, 4, 1, 5, 21, into total potential difference. I think you know, V1 is to V2 is to V3 is equals to, suppose 1 is to 2 is to 3. V1, what you write, 1 part of 6 parts into total potential difference. Same shortcut I'm applying there. Same total potential difference means here total temperature difference is how much, Nana? 105 minus 0. That is 105. So look at here, you are getting the answer 21 5s are, 5 4s are 20. Therefore, theta 1 is 105 minus 20. That is 85. So in the same way, you can find out the last one. Directly, you will get theta 2. Theta 2 is equals to 16 parts of total, 21 parts, into total temperature difference is 105. Here you will get 21 phi's are, 16 phi's are 80 degrees Celsius. So look at what the answer is. Okay. So the answers are like 20 and here 80 degrees. correct one. Right. This is 80 degrees Celsius. Okay. This is the story, Nana. By this, you can find out the theta 1 and theta 2 in one method. Or I feel that no need to write everything here, Nana. Straight away, I will get one equation. From that straight away, I am getting theta 1 and theta 2. If I know the concept V1 is to V2 is to V3 is equals to R1 is to R2 is to R. Okay. Whichever you are feeling comfortable, of course, you follow that method. I explained in two ways, Nana, two different methods. That is your wish. Okay. And number two here, suppose if you come to, again, back to like lower models, MZ type of exams, they won't ask for more than two rods. Just they ask only two rods. Two rods means here these two. What will be the temperature? Theta 1. Okay. One method, directly by equating these two, you will get the answer. By putting like this is KAL, 2KL, 2K, and here instead of theta 2, straight away I am maintaining 0 degrees Celsius. Okay. So here in this equation, theta 2, you can put 0 and directly you can find out theta 1. That is one method. Okay. And if you want another shortcut for this, the temperature at a junction by equating these two without numericals and solve theta 1, you will get like sigma K A theta by L by sigma K A by L. Okay, this type of formula you can see in all books now. Okay, that will be one shortcut. Right? Like K1, A1, theta 1 by L1 plus K2, A2 for two rods. K2, A2, theta 2 by L2 by K1, A1 by L1 plus K2, A2 by L2. Okay? And here, generally, that's what I'm saying. In MCET type of exams, in series, they take same area of cross-section. Means many conditions are there when you come to MCET. Areas of cross-section, same means here area term won't be there. Both have same area of cross-section. So the equation will be still simpler. Simpler. This is sigma k theta by L by sigma k by L. Okay, particularly for two rods. Okay, and that equation, one more advantage here, suppose one more rod is there, you can find out. Okay, but problem is the total part, suppose here three rods are taken. To find out the temperature theta here, we have to consider the total part as a single rod. Single rod means we have to come to know what is the effective thing. Okay. That one here I am asking. Suppose in my this example, okay, this is MCET shortcut now. Okay. And here in this example, if I ask, suppose what is the total amount of heat flowing through the rod? Okay. Means, yeah, after finding out theta 1 and theta 2. Here, if I ask, instead of theta 1 and theta 2, what is the total amount of heat flowing through the rod? Then what do you say, Nana, from your side? Right. So here, the resistance of the total rod I found here, that resistance I took here, if you don't know theta 1 and theta 2, then again, I apply the Ohm's law. What he is asking, what is Q by T through the three rods? Since they are in series, Q by T is constant. Therefore, that Q by T, total current is equals to total potential difference by total resistance. Total potential difference, total temperature difference here, 105 minus 0. That is 105 divided by R. Here you are getting 21 L by 4 K A. Okay. Now you are getting the answer. Okay. 21 exactly 5 za, 5 4 za, 20 K A by L. Okay. Previously by substituting here 85 and 105, how much you are getting? Same. 20 K A by L. Look at in two different ways. If you know the temperature, this is one method. And if you don't know the temperature, how to solve for the total heat flowing through the rate of heat flowing through the three rods? That is one method. Here we applied what? the resistance, secondary electricity part only. Okay. And in this case, what he is asking, find out effective K of the material, means of the system. Effective K means what, Nana? While finding out the effective K of this system, okay, I have to assume that the first one, I am not changing the dimensions, Nana. Its length is L, as usual, area of cross section is A. Second one, here also I am not changing the dimensions. Okay, its length is L and area of cross section is 2A. Third one, there also I am not changing the dimensions. Its length is 2L and area of cross section is A by. Okay, here actually the three parts are made with different materials, like K, 2K and K, right? At that time, you found what is Q by T. This is 20K A by L, right? If all the three are made of same material, some K dash, K dash and K dash, okay? Look at the three parts are made of same material, okay? Then you should get same Q by T, okay? Means same current in current electricity, right? Simple number. Here, these are three resistors, 1, 2, 3, and this is connected to some 6 volts battery. Here, what is the current? Current is equals to, sir, this is 1 ampere, sir. Okay, very good. What is the effective resistance means? The three resistors are replaced by one single resistor, okay, to get the same current. Okay, to get the same current means that resistance should be 6 ohms. Then only you will get the same current. Then it is called as effective resistance. Okay, effective resistance. Actually, what you took there? 1, 2, 3. When you get 6, by adding these values, therefore, effective resistance in series is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R2. This is the meaning of finding out the effective manner. Okay. Since they are in series, here the three rods using the same common sense from electricity. Okay. Here Q by T should be constant. When the three resistors, the three materials are replaced by a single material, like single resistor 6 ohm, to get the same Q by T. Okay. Then what is the effective K I am asking there? Right? So effective K means here what I am saying, the Q by T before replacing should be equals to the Q by T after replacing. Okay? Before replacing, already you calculated. Otherwise, what I write L by, Q by T is equal to K1 A1 into delta theta 1 by L1 first rod plus K2 A2 into delta theta 2 by L2 for the second rod plus K. This is what, Nana? Q by T, sorry. Q by T is same. The three rods are in series, means L1 by K1 A1 of the first rod plus L2 by K2 A2 of the second rod plus L3 by K3 A3 of the third rod means total resistance, like 1 plus 2 plus 3, should be equals to the resistance here after replacing. That should be equals to 6 ohms. After replacing means all the three don't have the same length. All the three, they don't have same area of cross section. That's why again I have to find out for the each part. The resistance of the first part is L by K dash into A plus second one, L by K dash into 2A, third part, 2L by K dash into A1. Means if I substitute the values here, L1 by K1, A1 is A, L2 by K2, this is 2K, into A2, that is 2A. By plus L3 is 2L by K3 K into A3 A by. I think you understood here before replacing, after replacing, means before replacing with the single material, after replacing with single material, the total resistance should be same. That is the meaning of effective K lambda. Okay, from there we have to find out what is K dash. Okay, what is K dash here? Straight away, I think you can solve that. Okay, by cancelling both sides, L by K. Simple, it is. What is this now? K na. This is 1 by K plus this is 1 by 4K plus this is 4 by K is equals to here you will get this is 1 by K dash plus this is 1 by 2K dash plus that is 4 by K dash. Okay, you can take K common on the right hand side. You can take K dash common. You can take LCM and you can solve the answer. Okay, this is the story. And these two are not equal. Anna appear to be first here same, last and last are appear to be same, but the middle parts are not equal. That's why you won't get the same thing. Okay, you will get some other answer. Okay, I think already you solved it. You got the answer for it. In this question, I am asking, what is the temperature at this junction and what is the temperature at that junction, like A and B? Okay, since it is balanced Wheatstone bridge, I removed the fifth resistor here, 5K. Then here this is 100K, these two are in series. Upper part. These two are also series, of course, same value. And it is theta. Upper resistance is equal to lower resistance. Upper resistance R is equal to L by K. Means R1 is equal to L by K. R2 is equal to L by 2K into A. Suppose R1 is some x, R2 is equals to x by x plus x by 2, 3x by 2. Here also x plus x by 2, 3x by 2. This is k, so x. That is also k, so x. Okay, happy. 3x by 2, 3x by 2 in parallel. So I will get here x, theta 1. This is parallel, means 3x by 4. Effective resistance, and this is theta 2, and it is x, and it is 0 resistance. So very simple, they are in series. So happy. I is same, so V by R constant.
Sir, theta 2 300/8, theta 1 500/8, sir.
Oh, very good. Theta 1 is 500/8. Very good, very good, ma'am. That's it. I think no need to solve it. Here it is on the board. Using the Ohm's law, I think you solved. All of you got the same answer, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Ah, okay, right. So nothing wrong in it. Okay, good. In this concentric cylinder, you place one material in this hollow part. Insert one material whose length is exactly equal to the length of the cylinder. Okay, take the radii as, here the radius you take it as R and outer radius you take it as 2R number. Okay, and it is filled with a material of 2K. Okay, here the total part of means except this hollow part, here this part. Okay, better I draw like this. This part and here this part. Okay, remaining part is made of material K. Okay, and here I am saying, if I ask what is the heat flow through this composite rod, if I maintain the temperature at the ends is 100 and 0, I think you can solve them. They are appeared like parallel or series, Nana?
Parallel, sir.
Why? Yeah, good. Why? Because delta theta is constant for the two parts, the concentric cylinder and rod. Okay, delta theta is constant, means potential difference is constant in electricity. So they are said to be in parallel. So I think you can calculate what is Q by T by using the formula 1 by R is equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Okay, will you say that quickly, Nana? What is the effective resistance? R is L by KA. So KA by L of first one, KA by L of second one. L same, okay. So 1 by R is equals to 1 by L common, K1, K, area of cross section, K2, 2K into area of cross section is pi R square. This is 4 pi R square minus pi R square, 3 pi R square. Okay, I got pi r square by L into 3k plus 2. Now I got this one, r is equals to L by 5k into pi r square. He is asking what is Q by T. Then apply Ohm's law. V, V means delta theta is equals to I into R. I is Q by T into R. Okay, so V, potential difference, here temperature difference is 100. 100 is equals to Q by T into R. Already I calculated L by 5K into pi R. From this you can find out what is Q by T. Okay, this is one model, Nana. And take care about the units also. Okay, generally K unit is watt per meter square degree Celsius, Nana. Okay, or Kelvin. What means joules per second? Okay, if they give this one in calories per second centimeter square Kelvin, then try to convert. Okay, joule into 4.2 meter square, centimeter square means into 10 power 4. So 4.2 into 10 power 4, that is 420 calories per centimeter square Kelvin second is equals to SI unit, watt per meter square Kelvin. Okay, while solving the numericals, take this conversion if they give in CGS system. And if they give calorie per second meter square Kelvin, just we have to convert calorie into joule, that you know, 4.4. Okay, so watt per meter square Kelvin is equals to just 4.2 calorie per meter square Kelvin second. Okay. So sometimes just with the conversions, we may lose the question sometimes. Okay. This is one method, Nana. This is what when the radiation is. Nana, in this case, if they ask effective theorem. In that erased diagram, effective K. Just you tell the method, that's it. You did not follow what I said previously.
2k by 3, sir.
Oh, you already calculated. Means what you did, Nana, 1 by R before is equals to 1 by R after. Am I right?
By 1 by K1 plus 1 by K2, sir.
No, Nana. Don't do mistakes like. I said effective resistance before is equals to effective resistance after. Okay. Resistance is L by K era, L is constant, but K and A are not constant. This 1 by R means 1 by before replacing, already you calculated here. This is 1 by R is L by 5K into pi R square. You already calculated before replacing these two here in this given diagram. I think inner one I took K, outer one K. Am I right, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
In my diagram. After replacing means total cylinder is replaced, not two materials, with a single material of K dash. Single material of K dash means after replacing with a single material, the effective resistance means 1 by R. Here you wrote 1 by R now. Okay, 1 by R, 1 by R is L by K, K dash, K into A. A means what is the total area. Why? Because inner part, hollow part and this part, both are made of same material. Same material means it is appeared like a single rod. Single rod of radius 2R. L by K, A. A is pi R square. Pi into 4R square. So here you are getting 5k into pi r square by L is equals to k dash into 4 pi r square by L. Look at, you got there k dash is equals to 5k now. Okay. So k in series, k in parallel means k in series is not equals to k1 plus k2 now.
Sir, 5k by 4, sir.
4, where I missed it? Oh, sorry. This 4 also I cancel. Right. 5k by 4. Okay. And keep in mind 1 by k in parallel is not equals to 1 by k1 plus 1 by k2. Okay. Keep in mind. So don't do that mistake in examination hall, particularly in conduction. Okay. Even though they gave many conditions like in MCET type of exam. Okay. Many conditions is what I am saying. In series, both are made of different materials, of course, like K1 and K2. But dimensions are same. Okay, what is the effective K means? If you see here, before replacing R1 plus R2, R1 means L by K1A plus R2, L by K2A, R1 plus R2 is equals to, after replacing, you tell Nana, both are made of same material, single material K dash. So,
L by K dash into A. Plus L by K dash into A.
Very good. L by K dash into A. Okay. So, here look at L by A may get cancelled. So, 1 by K1 plus 1 by K2 is equals to 2 by K dash. Okay. Even though you are not getting 1 by k is equals to 1 by k1 plus 1 by k2, okay, what I wrote here completely wrong, okay, even though if you write 1 by k dash is equals to 1 by k1 plus 1 by k2 under many conditions here, okay, this is also wrong what I am saying. That's why total resistance before replacing is equals to total resistance after replacing, whether they are in series or parallel. Okay, don't forget that basic, the basic form. Okay, and here, Papa. Excuse me, here, if I ask one question here related to conduction, so that we can complete the conduction part at least today. In this conduction, Anna, till now what we did, if it is the rod, when heat flows parallel to the length, that is perpendicular to area of cross section, then what is the Q by T? That we calculated, just completed that part also in different modes. Okay. Even though, don't worry, Nana, if K is different, okay, just try to apply the integration part. Suppose K is changing with the temperature directly proportional to root T, means K is equals to B root T given. Simple, but don't forget the basic concept. Q by T, in steady state, it is a constant, Nana. So don't write it as dQ by dT and try to integrate. This is Q by T only. That is constant. Is equals to K, better you write it as B root T, temperature, into A, area of cross section, into delta theta, you write it as dT, by L, a small part here of length dx. Okay. So now I think you understood how to integrate Q by T into dx is equals to, by A also you take here, B also you take here, Q by T, B, A, dx. Then you are getting here root T into dt. Then you can integrate x, what the things I took, Nana, here, length, the thickness I took here. So x limits are length limits like 0 to L. Okay. And root T limits here, hotter temperature T1, colder temperature is T2. Then colder you put at the lower limit, T1 you put it at the upper limit. Okay, and by integrating, you will get the heat flow Q by T also there. Right? So don't worry, don't leave even though the K is changing with the temperature. Just use the integration method. Yeah, this is simple integration. I think you understood. Area of cross section anywhere is not changing, it is constant. So for dx part, I assumed the change in temperature as dt. Okay, so delta theta is dt for dx part, length is dx. That's it. Okay, don't worry. And here, what I'm asking, suppose this is one rod, Nana. Okay. And here there is some hollow part, small part here of inner radius, say some r1, and outer radius, say r2. And here in this inner part, I am placing one heating coil, means source of heat. Okay, look at there. I am not maintaining the temperature difference at the two ends. Directly, this total part is filled with one heating source. Okay, then here these two parts are insulated, the sides are logged. Then there is no way to come the heat through the side walls. So surely the heat should flow through the material. This is solid material on the inside. Okay, this is the hollow part. That part is filled with the source of heat. And heat should flow like this. Okay, perpendicular to the what length, parallel to area of cross section. Okay, in that case, of course, in steady state, what will be Q by T if they ask? Use a bit simple common sense manner. Here, when the heat is flowing perpendicular to the length, okay, if I assume a small part here, like a cylinder. This is the assumed part of certain thickness. Okay, of certain thickness. That thickness, I am taking it as a dx, and radius of that assumed hollow cylinder is x. Okay, then to use the basic formula K A delta theta by L, identify the things, Nana, there. Who is A? Who is delta theta? Of course, delta theta will be between these two ends. I don't know the temperature difference. Let it be some D theta. Okay. Delta theta by L and area. Try to predict. You try to predict first what will be the length of that part.
Dx, sir.
Very good. Length is dx. Length means, that's what I'm saying from the beginning. Length is, we have to measure in the direction of heat flow. In the direction of heat flow, the length of this part is dx. Very good. That is dx. And area, Nana?
Pi x square, sir.
That is wrong, Tali. Okay. Pi x square, if you say, you are taking the total area. Okay. And that too, you are saying the area of cross section. Area of cross section, you are saying parallel to the direction of heat flow. But area of cross section should be perpendicular to the direction of heat flow. Perpendicular means you have to say the area perpendicular to this direction. Means in this direction, you have to say the area. Cylinder, Nana, in that direction, what is the area? I think parallel to the length, the area of cylinder means that is the surface area will come, Nana, parallel to the length. Surface area, I think you know the formula 2 pi RL. Okay? So, I think you understood. Is it clear, Nana?
Yes, sir.
2 pi RL. So, area of cross section we have to measure perpendicular to the direction of heat flow. Perpendicular means coming parallel to the length. Parallel to the length for the cylinder, we are getting surface area. surface area is, I think you can say 2 pi radius of this assumed cylinder is x into length of that one is nothing but length of original cylinder. Okay, if I give that hint, I think no need to explain further. Okay, simple, how to solve, you know, q by t into dx by x is equals to 2 pi k here into L constant into d theta integrating both sides. That's it, over now. Okay, and here will you say the limits, ra? Temperature limits, of course, I take theta 1 to theta 2. Okay, higher temperature theta 1, lower temperature theta 2. Here x limits, Nana? X is what? Radius or something?
Radius, sir.
I already give inner radius and outer radius values, na?
R1 to R2.
That's it, over. What is that? Okay. So, Q by T, that integration, you know, log X and finally you will get some Q by T value. So, understood that method, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Then, practically, when you come to numericals, where we use this lateral conduction, sir. Lateral conduction means the conduction perpendicular to the length. Okay. They asked previously, this is one lake at Anana, not India map. This is one lake. Okay. And consider here at the top, the area of cross section means surface area, lake surface area will be same. Okay. And here the temperature of surroundings means atmospheric temperature is like minus theta degrees Celsius, like in cold countries. Okay. Then obviously, even in Kashmir also we see at in winter season, the lakes, the surface of lakes will be frozen. Okay. So here, suppose the surface of lake is frozen to certain thickness. Already it has some thickness X. Okay. To grow that thickness, say from X1 to X2 or from thickness, some better we take, okay, some x1 to x2. Okay, to increase the thickness of this one, okay, what is the time taken? If they ask this question given in exam and already given in exam related to that radial conduction, lateral conduction, okay, related to that concept. So here I think you know, in lakes from first year, due to anomalous expansion of water, okay, the bottom will be at 4 degrees Celsius, that I think you know, and the top will be at 0 degrees Celsius. Means the water layer, which is in contact with already formed ice, is at 0 degrees Celsius. Okay, and suppose the thermal conductivity of ice is K, okay. Look at here, 0 and minus theta, I think 0 is at higher temperature, that is negative temperature. That's why heat tries to flow from higher temperature to lower temperature, it tries to flow like this, to the atmosphere. Whatever the heat there in the water at 0 degrees Celsius. Okay, while flowing, it is passing through whom? Ice. Ice is a solid. Solid means concept related to conduction. Conduction, our formula, Q by T is equals to here. Q by T is equal to K A delta theta by L. Okay. Now you say, Nana, what are the area and length? Delta theta, you tell. Higher 0 minus of minus theta, that is theta. This L, how much you write here?
X, sir.
X or DX, sir?
DX, sir.
You say first. DX,
sir? We didn't took the DX term there, sir.
Yeah. This is already, I assumed, some part of ice is formed.
As X.
Yeah. Very good. X. Right. Here, area. Area of cross-section or surface area?
Surface area.
Very good. I said already that surface area of that lake is constant, A. So A is constant, K is constant. Okay, keep in mind. And already here between these two, always the temperature difference is theta only. So it is also constant. Then who are variables are how to integrate this part? Okay, who is losing the heat, Nana? This water is losing the heat. Water at 0 degrees suppose loses some amount of heat immediately in thermodynamics. At 0 degrees centigrade, water suppose lost the heat immediately, it will be converted into ice. Converted into ice means it is a concept related to change of state. Change of state, Q, I have to write it as ML. Am I right, Nana? Or MS delta T?
ML.
ML. Is equals to K, A, theta, all the three things are constant by X. Now look at, if this part is also converted into ice, the thickness of ice is increased or not?
Yes, sir.
Increased. Yes.
So X is variable, what we found. K theta constant, L is constant. But here the part of water losing the amount of heat to the atmosphere. Next one, this part will come none. So this mass is variable. That I take it as dm. Okay. By here, if thickness changes, obviously the length of ice through which heat should flow will be increased. Okay. So obviously time will be changed. Let it be taken. Okay. That mass I write, Nana, as density into volume. Volume means area into thickness, area into, previously you told now there is no dx term, sir. Yes, this part of water is losing the heat. That in this direction already I consider it as x. So it will be dx. Okay, so density into volume is area into thickness, thickness is dx. Into L by dt is equals to Ka theta by x. So understood this part, Nana, what I took there?
Yes, sir.
Then I think no need to explain to you. You can do that. Okay? By rearranging the terms, rho, A cancel. I think you understood it is independent of surface area of lake. Okay? So rho L by K theta, all are constants. So you are going to do here x dx is equals to b. By integrating both those limits, you can say the answer is asking from x1 to x2. This is 0. So understood, Nana?
Yes, sir.
This is one method here. How to increase the thickness of ice formed at the surface of a lake in cold countries. Okay, right, good. So this is radial conduction, Nana.